Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear students, how are you? I think all of you are safe and sound, and all of you are staying at home to keep yourself safe from COVID-19. I am Muhammad Abdul Malik, assistant teacher of English by Shay Secondary School. I welcome to my online class today, dear students of class 8. In my previous class, I taught you Unit 6, Lesson 1. Today, I am going to teach you Unit 6, Lesson 2, and the title of the lesson is Filling in a form. That means how to give some specific information in a form before going abroad. And this form filling up is in the immigration office. Dear students, take your textbook in your hand and then you will see there is a form at page number 62. In this form, there are some options. The first option is the name of the passenger. Then, the gender of the passenger, male or female. The third option is DOB, that means date of birth. Fourth option, nationality. Our nationality is Bangladeshi. Then passport number. Sixth option, date of expiry. That means the last date of your passport. Then flight number, date of departure, and then address in Bangladesh. If you are a foreigner, then you will have to write this option. You will have to give an address where you stayed in Bangladesh. And for the native Bangladeshi people, this option must not be filled up. The 10th option for Bangladesh nationals, visa number, date of expiry of your visa, type of visa, and purpose of visit. And at the end of the form, there is an option of putting signature of the passenger, and under this signature you will have to put your date. In the right part, there is a space for giving seal. This seal will be given by the immigration officer. Dear students, in this way, if you want to go abroad, that means if you want to visit a foreign country, you will have to fill in this form in the immigration officer, in the immigration office. So there is a form in your textbook, and you will practice how to fill this form, how to fill in this form at home. Dear students, now we will go through the text and we will come to learn another thing. Mita's full name is Mita Sultana Ahmed. She was born on 6 May 1998. She got her passport on June 9, 2010. It's a 5-year passport. That means the duration of the passport is 5 years. It will expire on 8 June 2015. After that, she has to renew her passport. Dear student, there is a new word, I think. Perhaps most of you know the meaning of the word. Though you know, I have to write it. Renew. What do you mean by renew? Renew means start or freshen. Restart or freshen. That means to start anything again, to start anything again, or to freshen anything, or to freshen any old thing. If your passport becomes old, that means if the duration of your passport becomes over, you will have to restart the passport. That means you will have to take permission again. Next sentence, her passport number is AB984251. She is going to Thailand by Bangladesh Viman, flight number BD88 on 14 July 2012. Mita got her visa from the Royal Thai Embassy in Dhaka. Her visa number is T901-5138. The visa was issued in Dhaka on 29 June 2012. Dear students, we have got another new word, visa. What do you mean by visa? This word is quite known to all of us, but do you know what is the meaning of visa? A permission card. A permission card for going abroad and the duration is written, or the purpose of your visit is written on this visa card. So we have come to know that visa means a permission card for going abroad, on which the purpose of visit, date of visit, and the duration of my staying in a foreign country is written. Okay, it is visa. Dear students, the visa is valid for 3 months. That means Mita's visa is valid for 3 months. It will expire on September 27, 2012. It is a tourist visa. If you are traveling on a tourist visa, you are not allowed to study or work there. That means, dear students, there are several kinds of visa, and one of them is tourist visa. And Mita is going to Thailand to visit Thailand. So she has taken a tourist visa, and those who take tourist visa, they are not allowed to work in that country or to study in that country. Dear students, we have come to learn many things from this text, and at home all of you will answer to the related questions from your reference book. You can follow any kind of reference book. If you find any problem, you can throw any question in the comment box, or you can contact with me. And dear students, all of you, you will share this online class in Facebook or YouTube channel so that your all other classmates can enjoy this class. Dear students, in the next class, I will teach English second paper, and I firstly welcome you to attend my second paper class. Thank you today for attending this class. Allah Hafiz.